Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to today's TokenPost interview. Today we have Mr. Simon Pearson, the founder of B21. Welcome, Simon.
Hi.
So, Simon, could you tell us a bit about yourself? Could you give a brief introduction about yourself and how you got into the crypto business?
Sure. I trained as an accountant, spent 15 years almost in investment banking, created left investment banking to join an equities fund, and then from there went to develop my own fund, created, run, sold a sort of small investment account managed platform. Sold that a few years ago, went away and started investing, looking at my own portfolio. I've been in around Gibraltar for about 10 years, and it's quite a mix of a lot of crypto-based businesses. And a number of my friends were already in the business, in the industry. My personal lawyer was trying to kick me into investing and getting into the space. And then I had a couple of friends that joined tokenmarket.net, the CFO, Magnus, I know very well, personal, really good friend of mine. And from there, I bought a couple of equity investments, more private equity, which is what I was used to at the time, one into one exchange based in Switzerland. And that was really the catalyst for me to get into crypto. And from then, lots of ICOs, lots of coins, and a bit of advisory work. I've taken most of the advisory works off my sort of media profile, except for one, which I'm still advising, and have really just gotten into a project that I really like, which was developed from friends and conversations, and really been working on it since around middle of last year.
So I'm curious to ask, how did the name B21 come from?
The original genesis for B21 was, well, I can say block 21, but it's 1 in 21 million Bitcoin, really, is the idea. The original idea was to allow people to invest into Bitcoin to save to own one Bitcoin. So they would be 1 in 21 million, basically. That was the idea.
So could you give a brief introduction on how B21 works and how it's different from other platforms?
Yeah, sure. So B21, building the largest crypto asset investing community on the planet. That's the aim. The biggest differentiation to start with is the fact that we are at the final stages of our application for regulatory license in Gibraltar. And the regulatory license allows us to hold private keys, wallets, cold storage, and also allows us to provide discretionary and investment advice.
So is B21 based on a token economy of itself, or does it run simply on as a finance platform?
So the actual basis for B21 is a fintech type business, but a consumer play. The token itself runs in exactly the same way as Binance does, except for the burn, which we were legally advised to remove the burn. Mm-hmm. So we have a referral scheme, we have rewards inside and a discounting scheme for ownership. Then based on ownership, there's access to a VIP platform, which allows you to take investment advice and our sort of tailored portfolios for investment. Mm.
So since you're a fintech related platform, mm-hmm. do regulations such as KYC, Know Your Customer, affect or threat your platform or business?
100%. So I've spent a lot of time in the last few weeks finalizing our application our regulatory framework. And for me, KYC is essential from the outset. So we are KYCing every single penny that comes into the platform that complies with POCA, which is Proceeds of Crime Act, which is a sort of standard set for Gibraltar, which defines it from the UK, basically. And it complies with all the basic banking KYC AML processes that exist right now.
So when giving advices, how would you, like, what would be the most crucial advice that you would give?
In the investment world is don't invest any money that you can't afford to lose.
No.
That's the primary goal. That's the primary message. So you always need to be, you can't go and mortgage your house to go and invest on in this world. That's the idea.
So does B21 have any financial measures to protect its investors against the volatility of cryptocurrency?
Well, when people are self-selecting their own coins, they're selecting the coins that they wish to be invested into. So the answer to that in short order is no, because people are investing into the volatility of the coin they're investing into. When it comes to the investment managed portfolio and people choose a type of portfolio that, that reflects a balanced risk, then yes, there'll be an element of investments into things that have much less volatility to them. So the world is developing into a much wider space and if you like, if you take Tether as an example, but then you extend that over to all of the other security-based tokens that are pegged to different currencies, pegged to commodities, real estate, you know, those are less volatile instruments and are, not, you know, are actually tied, if they're credited in the right way, with the right collateralization, they're tied to things that have less volatility. That's the idea.
Of course, of course. How do you view the current outlook on the cryptocurrency market?
I think the market is always going to be volatile in this sort of infancy stage. I think there is so many eyes viewing the space. The actual blockchain technology underpinning the cryptocurrency market is here to stay. That's unequivocal. And we are right at the tip of the iceberg in terms of the potential for the industry to take off. Current valuation of the industry it changes every week. 400 billion, let's say. There are some quotes in the market that it's in the tens of trillions in the future. A little analogizing it back to the sort of dot-com type boom. And if you look at the sort of the wealth creation right now, what we're trying to do is to try and decentralize that wealth creation to allow people to create their own wealth.
Sure, sure. So is the product live currently, or when can those of us who are interested can expect your product?
We have a working prototype. We have a working model, but we're trying to make the model as seamless as possible. The product will be available sometime in July, for sure, and that sort of corresponds to when we should be regulated and be able to offer the full platform.
So, Simon, once again, thank you for a great interview. Any last comments to our audience?
No, B21, great. We're trying to work towards creating the biggest investment community globally, so please follow us.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in. That was Simon Pearson, the founder of B21. Thank you for watching.
Thank you.